Hello, I'm Audrey Jowers, one of the dietitians from the Our Healthy Heart program at Atherotech, and I'm here today to talk with you about what the VAP Lipid Panel means for you. By taking the VAP Lipid Panel, you have taken the first step to better health. Congratulations. But you may be asking, how does the VAP Lipid Panel help me improve my health? Good question. The VAP Lipid Panel shows important information that a basic lipid panel does not. When I talk about the basic lipid panel, I'm talking about a standard cholesterol test, LDL, HDL, triglycerides, total cholesterol. We know that high cholesterol is a risk factor for heart disease, but 50% of people that have a cardiac event have normal cholesterol levels. Where's the disconnect? Why is the risk in that 50% not being identified? This happens because there are limitations to the basic lipid panel. In evaluating LDL, which is the bad cholesterol, the basic lipid panel estimates LDL instead of measuring it. This estimation varies depending on the triglyceride level of the patient. The higher triglyceride levels, the higher the likelihood that the LDL will be inaccurate. But that's not the only problem. Besides the variability of the LDL numbers, the basic lipid panel overlooks residual risk, and therefore many patients who should be treated more aggressively for heart attack or stroke are not. They are left unaware. They're unaware they carry a strong genetic risk. They are unaware they have vascular inflammation. And they are unaware that they could be heading toward an insulin-resistant or pre-diabetic state. The VAP directly measures LDL, and it's accurate even in a non-fasting state. How many times have you scheduled your blood work and then forgotten you were supposed to fast beforehand? With the VAP, you don't have to worry about fasting. Even better, the VAP measures residual risk, hereditary markers, and detailed components of cholesterol that give you a comprehensive and accurate picture of your heart health and your risk. So what does this mean for you? This means you will know. You will know if you carry a strong genetic risk that could lead to heart attack. You will know if you have significant vascular inflammation that could lead to stroke. And you will know if you are or are becoming insulin resistant, which when treated can prevent the onset of diabetes. You will know because you had a VAP, and the VAP lipid panel reveals the risk.
Hi, my name is Kathy Stoner.
And I'm Megan Lindsay. We are registered dietitians with the Our Healthy Heart program from Atherotech, and we will be the ones going over your lab results with you. We're glad you've taken the first step by getting the VAP lipid panel. Now, let's look at what the VAP reveals to us.
Let's break it down by the type of risk that will be uncovered. We will look at markers associated with cholesterol disorders, triglyceride disorders, genetic risk, insulin resistance, and inflammation.
If you have an elevated LDL 4, 3, 2, 1, you have high, bad cholesterol, which can be reduced by some easy diet and lifestyle changes. LDL cholesterol, tips for improving your bad cholesterol. Number one, lose weight if you need to. Aim for a BMI between 18.5 and 25. Number two, exercise. Your goal for physical activity should be at least 30 minutes of exercise a day, 5 days a week. Walking, cycling, and other aerobic activities are best. Number three, limit fat, especially saturated fats, in your diet. Saturated fat is mainly found in foods from animals and some plants. First are cholesterol disorders: meat, butter, creams, cheeses, and other dairy products that are made from whole and 2% milk. Coconut oil, and palm kernel oil will also raise your LDL. Number four, aim for 10 to 25 grams of soluble fiber daily. Good sources of soluble fiber include oats, oat bran, barley, flax seeds, dried beans and peas, fruits and vegetables. Number five, incorporate monounsaturated fats into your diet. Good sources of monounsaturated or healthy fats include olive oil, peanut oil, canola oil, peanuts, pecans, almonds, and avocados. And last, incorporate sterols and stanols into your diet. Sterols and stanols are found naturally in fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, cereals, dried beans and peas, rice bran, and wheat germ. Many products, such as some margarines, have stanols and sterols added to them. Another component of LDL is a genetic risk factor called Lp(a). Lp(a) shows a hereditary risk of cardiovascular disease. If elevated, you may want to talk with your primary care physician about reducing your LDL target and more aggressively treating LDL and triglyceride disorders. Next are inflammatory markers. C-reactive protein, HS, will show nonspecific inflammation, which over time leads to increased cardiovascular disease risk. Lp(a)2, or the plaque test, shows the level of vascular inflammation, which if elevated, shows a higher risk of stroke.
Next, we're going to talk about triglyceride-rich disorders. This is a combination of abnormalities in any of these values: IDL, HDL2, VLDL, VLDL3, triglycerides, remnant lipoproteins, and LDL density pattern. To improve any of your triglyceride-rich disorders, lose weight if you need to. Exercise 30 minutes most days of the week. Stop smoking. Limit foods high in refined or highly processed carbohydrates, such as regular sodas, sugar, honey, corn syrup, candy, ice cream, cakes, and cookies. Increase intake in omega-3 fatty acids. Good sources of omega-3 fatty acids include fatty fish, walnuts, almonds, tofu, flaxseed oil, and canola oil. Choose foods that are low fat, especially low in saturated fats. Saturated fats are mostly found in your animal foods and some plant foods. Also, avoid alcohol. Lastly, let's look at insulin resistance and diabetes markers. Glucose, insulin, and HbA1c give us a clear indication of whether or not you are at risk for insulin resistance or diabetes. If glucose levels while fasting are over 100 or your HbA1c is over 5.6%, you need to limit refined carbs and sugars and adopt a carbohydrate-controlled diet plan. You also need to discuss these results with your primary care physician to determine if medication is warranted. To improve your glucose or any of your diabetes markers, lose weight if you need to. Even a 5 to 10% decrease in your body weight can greatly decrease your risk for developing diabetes. Exercise for 30 minutes most days of the week. Limit foods high in refined or highly processed carbohydrates and choose whole grains as often as possible. Don't skip meals. Plan on eating every 4 to 6 hours during the day to keep your blood sugar level and prevent overeating at mealtimes. Aim for 10 to 25 grams of soluble fiber each day. Soluble fiber is found in oats, oat bran, and fruits and vegetables. Aim for 10 to 25 grams of soluble fiber each day. Lastly, I'd like to show you a very simple eating plan called the plate method, which is beneficial in prevention as well as treatment of each and all of these disorders we've just discussed. Aim to fill a fourth of your plate with a lean protein, a fourth of your plate with whole grains or a high fiber carbohydrate, and half of your plate with a non-starchy vegetable like dark leafy greens, broccoli, summer squash, carrots, tomatoes, or green beans. Use a low-fat dairy or fresh fruit between meals as snacks. This method of eating will help you control your risk factors for heart disease and assist in controlling your weight.
This has just been a quick overview of what to expect when you receive your VAP lipid results. The VAP offers you a wealth of information, but can often be overwhelming. We, the dietitians of the Our Healthy Heart program, are here to help you understand your results and to provide you with diet and lifestyle modifications to help you improve your numbers and reduce your risk. We're glad you took the first step to better health, and we look forward to helping you each additional step of the way.